It's the Ron and Fez show. Back from vacation, 866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. Lily's sitting in with us. Lily, I talked to our friend Keisha, who used to be a producer for Ron and Fez. She's interested in trying a little show with you to see how the two of you would do.
Oh.
Everybody wants to do a show with you now.
Yeah, except for the Germ Freak.
The Germ Freak, you don't like. You don't get along with him.
I don't like him at all.
But Sam wants to do a show with you.
Yeah.
Did Davey Mack want to do a show?
I did. She turned me down. Mm-hmm. So now I'm still working for Dave the Crazed Live. Show of the future.
Glad.
But it's past tense. So
I'm glad that you don't take this seriously. That's really important.
I do take it seriously.
And it's your career.
I wanted to do a show with Lily, but she doesn't want to do one with me for some reason.
I'll do a show with you.
There you go.
Just for shits and giggles.
What's that even mean? Yeah. What does that mean?
I don't know.
You giggle when you shit?
Diarrhea and laughter.
Yeah. Well, I think Keisha and you would work off. It'd be like, it's like black chicks, white chicks. Who's not going to like that?
Yeah.
Like a zebra show with women.
I'm down for it.
You guys could be the woman version of Obama and Joe Biden.
They could be half of The View.
Oh, yeah, The View's back, huh?
Yeah.
They're done their summer break. And then I guess, doesn't the lesbian come into to New York to start it off every year? Ellen, doesn't she come to New York to a week?
She usually does.
Yeah. I don't know if she did. She's married now. Maybe she's not doing it.
You know what? I don't blame her either. I love her wife.
Yeah, she's hot.
Yeah, she couldn't have picked a better woman for herself. You know, that picture, though, with the two of them together, I think they should have both wore dresses. Yeah. I don't like to act like, well, I'm the boy in the relationship. You're a lesbian. You don't have to be the guy. You're still now, even though you're both lesbians, you're making up hetero rules for yourself. I would, even if I married another guy, I'd still want us both to wear dresses. I'd say, let's both put on a dress.
Yeah. I don't understand, like, full-blown lesbians, like the ones who put on strap-ons and stuff. It's like, if you want to get fucked by it, something
that's
like a penis. It's a real penis. Like, I don't get it.
Yeah, that's cheating, I think.
Yeah, it really is, because it's like, well, you're not supposed to like cock, so what are you doing?
If a lesbian wants a strap-on, then a guy should be able to come in and bang him. That's the way I would do it.
I agree.
Have you ever been to a lesbian wedding?
No. Mm. Never.
I went to one and I masturbated through the whole thing. Which they said was inappropriate. What like every other wedding. Yeah. But it was on the third floor. Don't go down to that third floor anymore, Dave.
Again, the stall goes to the ground. No one's ever going to see.
Boy, your baby got big over the vacation break,
Oh, God. Yeah. She's an actual human being now. I was the first person in the world to make her laugh, which I feel very happy about. And
then apparently she's never seen any old Red Buttons tapes because that guy was hysterical.
Well, we didn't have red buttons.
How'd you make her laugh?
I was doing this, like, cop puppet that I brought in, and the cop puppet is, he just tells her, you know, make sure you tie your shoes, and things like that, and, you know.
I don't even have any.
Wash your hands before you eat dinner.
Those aren't laws. Why is the cop saying that?
Where are the jokes?
Well, she liked the face of the cop.
Face!
And, yeah.
By the way, we got a little Jay Moore still on your face bit. Yeah. This is Jay Moore. What show was he doing, Hicks?
Fill in for Jim Rome.
All right, let's take a listen.
Face. Face. You know when it burns at UCLA? When you get a B-. Face.
All right, you know what's funny, clones? I got a guy in here. I came in early to put face into a microphone so we could push a button when I point to him. And apparently this guy's on, like, stucknut.com, ronfez.net, whackbag. He's on some kind of weird website. What are you doing that you can't... All I want you to do is hit the face button.
Face.
You know what I know the clones don't like? Is boom, out of here. They're livid over that. So if you can't get the face button ready, I gotta go to Brett Myers, boom, out of here for 2 hours.
Face.
What's this guy's name? Kyle. Just keep one eye on me. And when I point my finger, ready? Point.
Face.
Little too slow. Point.
Face.
That's the one I want. All right? Let's check this out. Oh, new medal count. United States, 81. China, 79.
Face.
We'll be right back after this.
See, I don't think Jay sounds very serious. He's always like this. Like, I'm hosting a show. I'm sitting here hosting. I'm going to act like I'm talking about sports. So he just steals your face thing.
Yeah, I'm not very happy about that. I know you're Mr. Hollywood.
Now, who are the clones? The Rome clones?
Yeah.
I didn't know
that's
that.
That's their fans.
I've seen his TV show. I never heard his radio show.
Yeah, well, I mean, just because, you know, you are a star, you know, and I've done very little with my life doesn't mean you can steal my thing. All right?
Well, I think you should be happy that it's out there like that. So far, both Opie and Jay Moore have stole your face bit.
Yeah. Then people are going to forget who the originator was. I'm fucking Steve Allen over
it
here.
It was also actually, and please don't hold this against me, it was that stupid Dane Cook movie. Has anybody brought this up?
Uh-uh.
That one of the guys in that movie, and I don't know why I was watching it, but he always goes, face. And he puts his hand like over his face. It's really weird.
Dane Cook now.
Which movie was it?
It wasn't Dane Cook who did it in the movie. It was the one with Jessica Simpson. I can't remember.
I'm going to be the best person at Walmart.
Yeah.
Sons of bitches.
It's a good movie though. If you like Walmart.
I don't.
All right, here's a little more Jay Moore.
Dear Jay, face, signed, Otis Nixon, Benito Santiago, Ron Cargavice, and Rosie O'Donnell, and Willie McGee. I added Willie McGee for you, Blaze. You left him off. Face! Play the other one on. Face! Ron Karkovice. That's a name that sounds like bad skin. That, I got news for you right there. Blaze and KC is that's huge email. Just stop sending them in. I don't want to hear any more emails regarding faces.
Wow.
Yeah.
I don't even think that was making sense.
I don't think he cares very much.
Well, I care about face.
Yeah.
And Mr. Moore, ask me next time. I thought we had that kind of relationship.
Why don't you take your cop puppet to talk to him? What's the puppet's name?
Copy.
Let me hear a copy.
Hey, Jay Moore, how's Gary and Mary doing?
Here's G-Man. G-Man, you're on Ron and Fez.
Jay Caller, 1229. Are you
ready?
Face!
Thanks. Dave, is it me or does that puppet sound an awful lot like Earl's dead grandmother?
I'm going to say this. Your impressions are shit. They run together.
Yeah, Earl's dead grandmother is far different.
She doesn't wear a uniform.
Yeah, I mean, Earl's dead grandma is more like,
hey, I really love sucking Tim Russett off in here in heaven.
And don't forget to tie your shoes.
God, Tony Randall's got a hard cock. Can't wait to fuck him in heaven.
Now make sure you wash your hands after pissing.
Oh, that's different.
It's the same thing.
Don't touch me. This
okay.
Dave, why does he always just do the same lame bit? Why can't you think of something new besides choking him?
Really?
What are you doing without a jacket on? You look like you're in PJs.
I do?
Yeah.
No, I don't wear a t-shirt and jeans.
I'm used to you. I never see you walk around in a t-shirt. You always have a jacket on.
Yeah, I mean, well, it's cool.
What happened in there? You jacket off?
No, I just took it off.
Does he ever do this? Jacket off time. Terry wants to give us a
face
update. What do you got for us, Terry?
Hey, you guys see Terry?
What can we do for you?
Yeah. Hey. Dan claims to have come up with that face. I heard Brian, that dog on that cartoon by Seth Green, Family Guy.
After me.
He said face one day.
After me. Check the records.
I think I remember little kids saying face, though. Years ago.
It was in your face, and then I, in the Spring Lake Posse, simplified it to simply face. Face. And I was the originator of the Spring Lake Posse, so I was the leader, so I get the credit.
So somebody else in there must have came up with it besides
no,
you.
I came up with it all by myself.
You should have gone the other way and shortened it to just in yours.
No.
The Spring Lake Pussies, you used to go everywhere
posse.
With them?
Spring Lake Posse.
Yeah.
And we were tough.
Yeah.
We used to kick those Spring Lake Heights assholes all over the place.
Get back to the Heights.
Brian, you're in Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ron, I've got a bad name for a great radio show. How about Pepper Hicks with LSD, Lily, Sam, and Dave?
LSD.
I think I like that.
What about a show just you and Pepper? Or is he too committed to that little Mexican kid?
Bronx Donnie?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean,
Johnny's not even Mexican, is he?
He's from Ecuador.
I thought Ben.
The other day, he was sitting here waiting for you, and he acted like he didn't know us.
Like, that was weird. So I saw that.
He would just be sitting here. He goes, I am just waiting for Pepper Hicks to get finished with his production work, and then I'm supposed to talk with him. I go, Johnny, I know you. Don't act like you can't go anywhere.
If you could, if you did Pepper Hicks' show, yeah. PH, you could say PH balanced for a man, but oh, suitable God. For Lily. I'm just trying to think of the hell. Fine, you know what? Fuck Lily and fuck Pepper.
Face, come on. Face.
I went on my clones.
Face.
Just try to help.
Freak Dog, you're on a Fez.
Hey, buddy, I got a spy report.
Oh, good. I need a spy report.
Spy report.
To really cheer me up today.
Country singer and co-star of Smokey and the Bandit, Jerry Reed, has passed away at the age of 71.
No. Oh. What happened?
Apparently, just might have been old age. His publicist just reported it. And
71 isn't old enough to die from old age. I bet it was a truck accident because he never, you know, he was not really careful. Why don't you play us the theme song, Earl? Grab us the theme song.
Would Fezzy consider him one of the four faces of the Southern Mount Rushmore?
Face. He's at least part of the Burt Reynolds Mount Rushmore.
But why has everything got a Mount Rushmore? Do you have it, Hicks? All right, let's take a little listen to a brother. I'm going to actually spell some of this out, too, for Jerry Reed. And for Willis Reed. His brother.
Oh, God.
Who's still alive, but his knee's bad.
Great player.
Now, here we go. This isn't it. Turn it off. Earl, why don't you grab one of the things? You know the films. You're around it. He doesn't know it. Come in here and grab your goddamn thing that you said you had to have. What is wrong with you?
Now, I just saw a wrestling DVD with Jerry Reed as part of it over the vacation.
I don't know even what to say back to that.
It just seems weird that I just saw Jerry. I mean, how often do you see Jerry Reed?
Smokey and the Bandit on TBS every weekend.
I didn't know that he was on any wrestling shows.
Yeah, he was doing like promos for Mid-South Wrestling. Just talking about how it's the greatest wrestling around and being very serious about it.
Now, this is what you watch during your vacation.
I got it and I popped it in. I wasn't going to any summer movies.
You still haven't seen Taxi Driver?
No, I have not seen that. I'm
have you returned it to Dave?
No.
Give him money right now.
Why?
Give him the money for that.
Honestly, I really want that and the War Room. I have such an itching to watch that D.A. Pennebaker classic with the elections.
Do you have these things at home?
I'm sure they're there somewhere.
Then bring them in tomorrow.
All right.
I'm tired of hearing about it.
I will look for them.
Thank you.
Joey. Joey, you're on Fez.
Yeah?
Yes.
Dave, you're full of shit, bro. We used to say face when I was in junior high. Oh,
bullshit. What face. Year?
Alabama.
What year?
That's not
Jerry.
A year.
I'm
that's the way of life.
Right now, and I was in junior high.
Well, I'm 30. I'll be 31 in November, so I'm older than you.
Say again?
I'll be 31 in November. I'm older than you. I started it.
Clay, you're on Run a Fez.
Yeah, hey, Dave. You ever heard of Curtis Blow?
Yeah, I've heard of him.
The song Basketball, where he says, face.
All right, let's take a listen. You know the song, Earl?
Was it Eastbound and Down?
No, my God.
It's called Basketball.
Are you fucking keeping up now? We've known gone now to Curtis Blow.
Basketball. The song is called Basketball.
Yes, Basketball by Curtis Blow. Yes, I know the song.
Now you got the Jerry Reed song? Fucking 20 minutes too late? Jesus Christ.
It's a good song, too, by Curtis Blow. But he stole it from me.
All right, let's take a listen. Let's see if we hear it in there.
They're playing basketball.
Face.
Oh, that's it.
What?
Face.
Yeah, I don't recall
it. I heard
this
it.
Version.
Face. Face.
Okay. This isn't.
Face.
No.
This is a great song.
You're pressing a button.
Face.
By the way, this is Obama's theme song.
Oh, I don't know if you're playing some sort of B-side, but this wasn't the original.
Face, Face. Uses it a lot.
Yeah.
Face.
Basketball is my favorite sport. I like to win it through and down the court. Just like out the king on the microphone. So it's Dr. J and Moses Malone. I like slam dunk.
Ow!
My favorite play is
face.
I like the pick and roll. I like the give and go. Cause it's basketball. But Mr. Curtis Blow.
Obama, 2008.
Take the girl to see Tiny play against Earl Pearl and Will Bingo and Jerry West. Play basketball at its very best. Basketball has always been my thing. I like Magic Bird and Bernard King. And number 33, my man Kirby is the center of my stalling team.
Face. 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 Face.
Yes, Clyde, Rick Perry, and Pistol Pete. Now these players could never be Isaiah and Iceman too.
Face.
Just give him the ball, and then you talk up too. Dantley and Williams are on the scene, and Ralph Sampson is really mean. Bill Russell didn't take no jump, and Dal Dawkins got a monster dunk.
Face, 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 to the hoop, face, y'all. Face,
yes,
face, face,
ha,
face,
ho, here
face,
I go.
Face,
face.
Can we take it back, girl? Just like one line before. Because he did yell at
this
face.
This song is the We Didn't Start the Fire of refs. He's just naming things.
And Ralph Sampson is really mean. Bill Russell didn't take no jump. And Dal Dawkins got a monster dunk. To the hoop, y'all. Yes. Here I go. Face.
Face.
Well.
Face. Face.
Can't check me, man.
Face.
Get on down.
Face.
Oh, yeah, I like this basketball. D up. Now, here I go. In your face. Swish.
Face.
Oh, yeah.
After this, Curtis Blow's going to do a song about brushing your teeth. Flossing.
Floss.
Boy, those are all rappers blue.
Really?
They were just the fucking worst.
It's like they sound when black people do impressions of how white people rap. That's how they sound. Like they fucking suck.
Why don't we just admit that white people rap like it's 85?
I went into the store. I picked up some donuts. Like, what the fuck?
It's a lot simpler then. What are you going to do?
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it was.
Bob Dylan had been out for 25 years.
A simpler time.
Just a lot
simpler.
The production, of course, wasn't as up to speed as it was then. You just had a little keyboard. You had a little sampling machine. That was it. That's you had to work on what you had.
And it's still blue. Here's Derek. You're in Manifest.
Yeah, this is Derek from St. Louis. I've been saying face since I was in grade school, and I'm 35.
Why is everybody going to steal this from Dave? Why can't he just have
bullshit.
His face thing?
Bullshit, Derek. Let me see proof.
Why can't this just be his thing?
This is my thing. This is my
no,
thing.
No, you lost it. No.
No.
You lost the Curtis Blow.
It's my thing, Opie. It's my thing, Mr. Hollywood.
Face, 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 face.
You got faced.
I didn't get faced by Curtis Blow.
Why don't you think just be shoulders? Shoulders!
Doesn't make sense.
First person I heard use face was Billy Crystal. Remember that fucking routine?
Face, I'm looking for you.
That's supposedly what jazz guys used to call women and little kids.
Oh, I don't recall that.
Yeah,
I recall face from
like
the
you 18. Call your chick your shouty. I'm going to my shouty side. Here's Max. Max, you're on Runnerfest.
Hey, Ronnie. Yeah. Billy Idol beat Dave. He did that song, Eyes Without a Face. See ya.
Eyes without a
face.
Oh,
my eyes without a
face.
That was it.
It's very hacky. No, Billy Idol was not before me. Remember,
reading murder books and trying to stay hip. Yeah, the 80s blew. The 80s might have been the worst fucking decade of men.
Bad clothes, bad outfit.
Bad clothes, bad hair, Guns N' Roses.
Hey,
just
hey,
fuck
hey,
what?
Hey.
What
no,
I say wrong?
The Guns N' Roses thing.
You gotta admit, worst decade for fucking movies ever.
Yeah, I would admit
terrible
that.
Movies.
Yeah, that's when the really bad formula kicked in on how to have, because it was sequel crazy. You yeah. know what I mean? It was like Ghostbusters 2, Ghostbusters 8. What was that?
No, there's only two.
I'm just saying, but Rocky 4.
You're wrong. You're wrong, Jerry Reed. You're wrong.
But it was just what a horrible
decade. All the movies were bad back then. Music was pretty awful.
And even, yeah, I was going to say, even like Dylan and Neil Young went down in the 80s.
They made their worst fucking music.
In the 80s.
Van Morrison made terrible 80s music.
Yeah.
No matter who it was, they could have been Rod Stewart, great in the early 70s, 80s, terrible. Mm.
Even Bruce.
Elton John, listen to his 70s stuff, then listen to his fucking 80s stuff. It's unbearable.
Bruce got carried away with the synthesizer.
Of course he did. He's dancing in the dark like a fucking idiot.
With Courtney Cox or whatever the fuck.
Why are you just going, I'm dancing with Courtney Cox? That would have been a great fucking song.
I think the 90s is still the best decade because you had the beginning of alternative, the best rap, Beck, and like we just mentioned, that's when
I will give you this. I'll give you the first half of the 90s. I'll put that up with the late 60s. Then by the time we got into Marcy's Playground, we were in some real fucking problems. I don't know what happened at the end of with the Creed and fucking Marcy's Playground. There was some bad shit at the end of the 90s.
And then you had
and
that
then
whole
boy bands.
Yeah, pop and Britney
Wouldn't
Spears
you
and all that.
Wouldn't you prefer, though, even a Marcy's Playground single no. to, like, I Want Candy or one of those other bullshit 80s, you know, yeah, I'm but, your Venus, I'm your fire.
Yeah, but you're comparing the pop with rock.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I mean, you still, Beck, you know, certainly put a big mark on the 90s in the mid and late 90s.
I'm going to agree with you, too. I mean, I think the early 90s was a fucking phenomenal time
yeah.
for rock. Phenomenal.
That was amazing.
It's forgotten about, where everybody keeps giving that to the 60s.
Yeah, and I mean, and you had probably the best rappers
all right,
of all
let's time. Let Earl decide. Earl, you will be the judge. But you have to say, you got to be like, here come the judge, here come the judge. And then you tell us what was the best decade for rock. Do your here comes the judge.
Here comes the judge, here come the judge, here come the judge.
Fucking stereotyping. Come on.
I think the 60s were better.
All right, there it is. The
You're
game is over.
You're a sellout.
We listen to the judge.
You're a sellout.
But everything came together.
Velvet Underground, Doors, Kinks, Who, Stones, Beatles.
Motown.
Motown, Bob Dylan. It's tough to fight that.
Well, you know, of course, Earl won't bring up hip hop, but what about Wu-Tang Clan, Biggie, Tupac?
He hates that stuff.
That's my point.
I mean,
do you think
decade...
that stuff is better than Motown?
Nineties
hip hop or Motown? What's better?
Motown's better.
Thank you.
But
no further
questions.
No further questions.
Even like the poppier stuff, like Sinatra was still making great records.
Oh, please. What? Scooby-Doo or whatever the fuck he was saying? His 60s stuff was terrible.
I mean, but the whole decade was just, it was part of a change. It was like a whole, it reflected the times and really...
The bigger bands of the late 60s were probably better than the bands of the early 90s. However... There's a million different underground and even lesser-known bands like, you know, Neutral Milk Hotel and Pavement and Luna. There's more bands, better bands overall in the 90s than the 60s. Don't get me wrong. Obviously, the Beatles are better than Pearl Jam. I'm not retarded. But...
Yes, you are.
But there's...
That has nothing to do with this argument.
But there's probably 50 solid rock bands in the 90s compared to 10 in the 60s. That would be my argument. There's more.
The bands that came out of England alone blow away anything that came out in the
90s. I mean, it's real fucking tough to come up. I mean, you could. It's really tough to fight that.
And that's the stereotype that the band, the British Invasion, the Kinks destroyed Nirvana.
But there is Nirvana without the Kinks. The Who.
I love the Who. I love
the Who and Nirvana. Make your pick right now. 3 seconds.
Nirvana.
Really?
I would have to say it. I think they have a bigger mark. So I'm going to say Nirvana over the Who. And I love the Who. You guys are putting me in impossible situations.
Here's Germ Freak. You're on Run a Fez.
Hey, what's going on, people? Dave, what you got to do is with these things that you, you know, these slogans and acronyms, you have to make people say, you know, copyright after it. So people will say copyright Eastside Dave, because whenever I develop acronyms and things of that words, people have to say copyright Germ Freak at the end.
What have you come up with, Germ Freak?
Well, I've come up with several acronyms like DWI for deal with it, TFB for too fucking bad.
I've come up with a lot of these things.
So you honestly feel proud of coming up with the acronym for Deal With It?
I do, because it sticks it to people a little. See, when you say...
That was the little girl in Kid Nation.
When you say
she didn't say DWI.
Oh.
When you say DWI to somebody, it sticks it to them a little harder, because you're not giving them the satisfaction of saying Deal With It. And by the way, is that Nellie there, or what's her name, Lily? Lily, we got a table for four in the back tonight for 7 o'clock, just FYI, okay?
Oh! Oh!
I don't understand that.
She's making fun of the, he's making fun of the fact that your dad is wealthy with a restaurant.
Yeah. You got me.
No problem. Thanks, guys.
All right, take it easy.
He's a 13-year-old girl. Yeah. WTF. What is that? What's wrong with him?
What the fuck? Why don't you do this? Why don't you steal his partner away from him?
That would be good. I don't like him anyway. No, I don't want. I want nothing to do with them.
You don't like
DJ New Style.
I was going to say DJ New Style. Oh, okay. Why are you interrupting me? For some reason, I was going to call him Hightower. I was going to be honest. I was going to say, you don't like Hightower? Why am I the only one who uses their real name? Why is it a fucking problem for people to have a first and last name?
Mike.
What's wrong with
that? Mike New Style.
I don't think New Styles is real.
Oh.
New.
DWI, Lily.
Deal. She can't.
DWI, B.
But he can't copyright that, because that's already an acronym or whatever it is.
Here's Anthony.
Dave, you're on drugs.
Oh, yes?
There is no chance Nirvana even measures up to the Kinks. Kurt Cobain is a pimple on Ray Davies' ball sack.
That's just
not here's
true.
The problem with this, though. Obviously, it comes down to taste. I am more impressed sometimes with people who came in early, where, let's face it, Ray Davies didn't have the catalog of music, rock music, to look at the way that Kurt Cobain did.
Yeah.
Ray Davies didn't go, hey, the Pixies were great. Why don't I try to get a Pixies sound going?
But
yes, sir.
And the Kinks, they, where a lot of the British bands were covering, like, they were covering Motown songs. He was writing from a strictly British perspective. You know what I mean?
Oh, and I wasn't.
Well, you were not.
So?
But
that doesn't take away from some of the stuff I did.
And to me, that was a lot more original, where...
Do you like the Kinks just because of that gay song? No. Look at the cross-dressing song?
No, I don't like it.
Because it's okay with me, down low.
No, I'm not down low.
DL.
But there's something to be said for people who take it up to another level. No, not the ass. Another level. I mean, are we more impressed with Usain Bolt or Carl Lewis? You know?
Bolt. Because,
right. Well, I'm saying Kurt Cobain saw what Ray Davies did, but last week
you told me that Carl Lewis was the greatest Olympian.
Oh, he
are
is.
You now saying Usain Bolt is?
I'm saying
Usain Bolt, no, Jamaica! Jamaica!
I was saying Usain Bolt's sprinting is insane, but Carl Lewis is definitely the best.
Would you
Olympian.
Say that it's insane in the membrane?
Another 90s band? Yes, I would.
Then let's just call people CHs, if we think they're crazy. You fucking CH.
Copyright it.
Here's copyright. You don't care much for the germ free.
No, how could you? He copyrights DWI? What is wrong with him?
You don't find him kind of adorable?
Not in the slightest.
MYJ, Lily. Maybe you're jealous.
I am jealous because he's friends with Barb.
She was over on Tuesday.
How was that?
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Just me staring at her.
Boring her to death.
Right.
Here's Catfish. What can we do for you, buddy?
Ronnie B, I've got a moral conundrum I want you to help me with.
Good.
I let you down, buddy. I had my sister-in-law. She went to Chicago. I made it a point to let her know to pick me up some Ronnie B cupcakes. And she let me down. And I wanted to know, what do I do here? Should I kill her or should I fuck her?
Well, where are you calling from?
North Carolina.
Yeah, just fuck her. Make sure she's not drunk first. 866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. I'm having trouble with... I'm worried about people now because they're not going to be traveling as much. And, you know, these cupcakes are such a hot item. Now, from what I understand, these are called the Cubs are calling these the Good Luck Cupcakes. They've been eating them every day, hopefully taking it all away. I wouldn't mind seeing the Cubs win the series this year.
Well, best record in baseball. It's...
And the Yanks are what, worse?
No.
There you
close.
Are.
We're hurting, yeah.
They're done.
Fez, you were just in Tampa. What is the Rays fever like down there? People having a fever?
There is no Rays fever.
None at all, really?
No. And, you know, people were, like, talking about if Jeff Garcia, you know, is he going to be ready for the Bucs season? And they have a playoff team that the team while I was down there, the Rays, actually, you know, secured their first winning season. Just comes and goes. I mean, I heard...
Like a karma chameleon?
Mm-hmm. Comes and goes. Yeah, I heard no one excited about Rays fever. No one.
So, this is like the greatest worst... This might be the greatest worst the first story ever, and no one cares down there?
They don't care. They're not baseball fans.
No.
The last game that they had was 14,000 people. And that's disgusting.
And that was bat day.
It was.
There's plenty of
tickets.
Did
you guys watch the thing going on right now? It's the latest HBO Sports about what it's going to cost to go to Yankee Stadium.
Yeah. And Giants and all that. Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, but Yankees was even worse.
That was terrible. Well, it would cost them $800,000 a year for every home game.
and this guy has had season tickets for... Since the 1970s. The seats that he has now in the new stadium would cost him $800,000 for the year.
Unbelievable. It's like he's paying for the new stadium himself.
And he has plenty of money.
Costs a little more than
what does he pay now?
Well, he said only in the last 3 years did it start to go up. When he first had those tickets, they were $6 a game. Yeah.
Wow.
Now I think I thought he was like...
It's like 100 or something.
80 to 100, yeah. 80 grand to 100,000.
Well, the sad part is, like, for every fan that complains, like, the waiting list for these things are astronomical. Like, I will never see a Jet game in my lifetime, ever, because the waiting list is so long. If I wanted to buy season tickets, they said it's like a 10-year waiting list, just to get considered for a ticket.
And you're not going
to
get good seats.
And, yeah, and there's no guarantee that there's no good seats, but I'm like, I'll never see a football, I've never seen an NFL
game.
I'm
telling you right now, when you had Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia, as shitty as that place was, it was filled with fucking Eagles fans. Now, the new stadium is filled with guys in suits and jackets. Who are these fucking guys?
Mm-hmm.
Who are these ham and eggers?
And the Giants are now going to pay or charge people $20,000 just to get on the list to buy tickets.
Right.
You have to pay 20 grand before you even fucking write a check.
Well,
they got to
know that you're fucking serious.
Well, I'm serious. I'll be on the waiting list for 15
Great.
Years.
We'd love to have you. I'll make $20,000.
I know, but there's something about those, like, I always call them the grits and gravy fans. That'll just stick it out. The suit guys, they never stick it out. Like, will they be there?
It doesn't
there?
Matter.
Will they be
the
there in April?
The money is just as fucking green.
I mean, but they won't be there in April when it's balls cold out. They won't
they
be
don't care. The seats will be paid for. Then you'll have a Tampa-type situation.
Mm.
All this stuff started when people started selling their tickets on the fucking internet. That fucked everything up for everybody else. When hometown fans started to sell their tickets. So now the teams are going, oh, so that's what a ticket's worth. It's not worth the fucking value. It's worth the resale value. And everybody's screwed now over that. Here's our good friend and longtime Giants ticket holder, Hard Rock Johnny. Hey, Johnny!
Hello, boys.
Johnny, where were you the other night? Fez was buying.
Yeah, I know. I never really got the invite. Thanks, Fez.
Fez, you owe him now.
I owe him.
Me and Eddie.
We said on the air we were going. I can't round up every little detail.
And Sheepy's upset, too. You didn't call him.
I mean, everybody heard on the air that you guys were going. Were they all? Everyone was invited?
Everyone knew. Hard Rock Johnny, you knew you were invited. And everyone knew that the semifinals.
Pick up a phone.
I miss the old Fez.
Pick up a phone.
Every now and then.
Make a call.
He knew.
What were we going to say, Jenny?
Giant season tickets. This whole thing, the seat licensing thing is just getting ridiculous. At least in, you know, some of the other stadiums where they do it, you actually own that seat for every event that comes into the stadium, so you have the right of first refusal for anything that comes through. Giant Stadium? No, just for, you know, 8 games a year. $50,000 is what it, you know. We have it's $5,000 a seat where our seats are now.
Oh, Jesus!
And we have 10 of them. It's a steep, you know. It's pretty steep.
Johnny, it might be time for you to fucking just back out on this team.
No, we're gonna figure it out. I mean, look, you know, we have, you know, we're gonna make it work, but it's just tough. And you know, the worst thing is, look,
You're breaking, it's a 30-year investment. Because that's the life of the stadium, they're saying 30 to 40 years. So if you actually break it down, a 30 years, eight games, it really is only like $5 to $7 per seat per game. But they want it all up front. And you know, they're saying it's to furnish a new stadium for the fans. Last time I checked, I didn't need a new stadium.
Right, you were happy.
Fans, right, I was happy sitting my fat ass in my seat and having no problem with it. You know, and you know, they needed the stadium. And the
you gotta admit, there is nothing wrong with Giants Stadium.
No.
That is not a hellhole.
No, it's a good stadium. You know, could the concourses be a little wider to help people get out faster? Yeah, absolutely. But the big thing is, the worst part of it all is the NFL is a revenue-sharing league. So the team that makes the least money still makes the same amount as the team that makes the most money.
Yeah.
So them saying that they needed a new stadium to make more money, they really don't, because it's all equal, because they share revenue. So the poor teams make as much as the rich teams. So they really weren't, they claim they weren't pulling their weight with the NFL. Well, did the NFL ask them to build a new stadium? Well, then they should pay for the seat licensing fees.
Yeah, it's all bullshit. And it's the fans take it in the ass one after another.
You know, I mean, you got guys, like you said, guys who've had season tickets on like 50-yard line. Now, those seats are $20,000 for the seat licensing. And then you got to pay $500 a game.
And let's face it, a great game is not worth $500.
No, nothing's worth it.
And you're not going by yourself. You got a kid with you, so that's $1,000.
Yeah, I mean,
the fuck are you talking about? I'll watch this game at home for free. For fucking free. Warm. And I'll use that $1,000 to buy fucking alcohol, dope, and food.
I'm coming to your place.
TV.
Johnny, listen. Mm-hmm. I want you to come out with Fezzy. He's going to dig you out. Eddie, of course, Casey didn't get invited. Who's upset right now?
Right, I forgot about that.
We'll wait.
Do you know Casey's upset, right?
No, I didn't know Casey was upset.
Well, you invited her best friend, but not her. It's like you slapping her across the face, she said, with your hairy ass cheeks.
He brought Costello in and he jizzed all over Abbott.
Is that good or bad?
I think it's bad. That was a terrible analogy in the long run.
I think it's a good one.
I don't know if it works.
Hey, Abbott! All right, Johnny, you're the best, buddy.
Thanks, boys.
I'll see you at Fez's big party.
Not having a big party.
Why not?
I already had one.
Well, don't you have another bet you're losing?
Well, I have the Dark Knight bet that I'm not really willing to give up yet. Dark Knight beating Titanic's domestic take.
All right, so Dark Knight made $8 million last week.
Yeah, it's up to $502 million.
By the way, congratulations for that, Fez.
Oh, thank you.
Not that you have anything to do
I'll
with
thank
it.
You.
I don't know why you get happy when someone else makes money.
And then Titanic's like $600,700,000. So I'm under $100 million.
Yeah, but they stop making money.
They're dead. I mean, Tropic Thunder being 3 weeks in a row.
And they're starting to pull it out of
which, by the way, is hideous. Did you see it?
No.
You don't see any of the movies?
We're not,
yeah. I'm the only one who sees movies.
Well, I mean...
By the way, I just watched The Whackness the other day.
Not good.
It reminded me of Fez. The fucking point comes to this. This chick said to him, I see the dopeness in everything, and you see the whackness in everything. And that's you, Fez. You see the whackness.
Yeah. I'm wacky. That's why.
Hmm? When are you going back in the Nut Hut?
Oh, I wasn't planning on going back in the Nut Hut. I'm going to see the therapist today, though.
What time?
She's warming up the couch. 6.
Why don't you do this? Have dynamite across your chest and go running in there and fucking blow that bitch out.
I'm sure she wouldn't be shocked to see me walk in that way.
Yeah. And then, in your religion, if you die, you're one of the 42 virgins.
That's not my religion. I'm Lutheran.
Brandon, you're in Manifest.
Hey, what's going on, buddies?
What do you say, pal?
Hey, Ronnie, I got to stick up for, the Rays here. I was just at Tropicana Field on Sunday, sitting in a sold-out stadium, and they were playing the Orioles. So, you know...
There is no way that game was sold out.
I swear to God.
It's on SportsCenter.
Even the upper deck, it was totally, totally full.
Fez, are you coming back with bad info?
No.
Has this fucking town got Ray fever?
It has nothing. I was there for a week. I actually heard the TV announcers at one game talk about the upcoming series where the Yankees go to Tampa Bay, saying, I hope we can get more Rays fans here for that series than Yankees fans.
I was in line for an hour. I mean, we got there right before the game, so I'm used to walking up to the box office, buying a ticket, walking in. No, there were lines all over the place. So it's
so you're saying Fez came back here with last month's news that the town is really getting fucking crazy about baseball.
It's getting there. It's taking a while. You know, they got to warm up to it and get off their butts, you know, but it's coming around.
I would think that that town would be going just batshit insane with an opportunity maybe to win the World Series.
Yeah, it shouldn't be warming up.
Why are you angry?
Because he's calling with misinformation.
But why does that make you angry?
Because it makes me look bad.
No, what makes you look bad is that shirt and beard.
Or the fact
information you're saying, far down on the list of what makes you look bad.
All right.
That Sergeant Carter haircut isn't working for you.
Yeah, it's in a transitional stage.
Making this up. There's nothing wrong with your hair. By transitional, you mean falling out?
Some.
Here's Craig. Craig, you're on the face.
Hey, buddies.
Yeah.
That's actually part of the reason why the licensing fees and all the high stadium costs, that's part of the reason for the resurgence in college sports. I heard you guys talking about the Tennessee-UCLA game. That actually got a 4.52 viewer rating last night, which is higher than the NBA Finals when the Spurs were in it.
Well, I told you this before. The fucking, that league is the number two league in America right now. The only thing bigger than college football is pro football. And those kids have the right to get paid. It's bullshit.
Paying.
Well, here's those fucking Rays getting paid, and they're selling out every game.
They are not selling out every
game. I just got a call that they sold out Sunday.
Don't listen to Pete.
He's from St. Pete. His name is a Pete.
Oh.
That's a city.
But he's no saint.
That's a city where you supposedly live. Were you even down there?
Yes, I was down there.
I got an idea for you teaming up with someone.
Yeah.
Brazilian Julie.
Is she in radio?
No, I meant sexually.
Oh.
No,
okay.
Look at her. She's
very attractive.
She's gorgeous. She's very, she's got all the cutting edge stuff.
I like how she's from Brazil.
I love that, too. Plus, you know, radio now is international.
Fucking A, Canada. Mm. Face to them.
Face.
Only the original.
Big up, Curtis Blow. Is he dead, Earl?
No, he's not dead. He's alive.
Too bad, then. I'm not going to pour any of my 40 out.
He's got this new song. I'm not dead. I'm still alive.
Doing alive and
why are you angry, too?
I'm not angry.
Who's angry as Watley?
I'm not angry. It's just like everyone always trashes early hip-hop. I'm like, you had to start somewhere. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
just
starting your shit.
It was terrible. His sequel, We're Playing Badminton.
That was terrible. That was fucking terrible song.
But anyway, you don't think Run DMC wasn't bad?
Yes.
They
were awful.
They weren't good.
LL Cool J?
I need love.
That was great.
I need love.
Will Smith was terrible. Did he get...
Wait a minute. Hold on.
Come on.
He got jiggy.
Parents just don't understand.
That was actually good. That one, and I think I could beat Mike Tyson with great singers. Here's Tony. Tony, you're on the Fez. Tony. Peace. Chris, you're on the Fez.
By the way, that was Big Daddy Kane that did the basketball song.
No, we just fucking pulled it.
Yeah. But, Georgia Bulldogs, ranked number one. Last year, they played Georgia State. It was $100 a ticket to get in 10 minutes before the game. 15 minutes before the game, the upper deck was still going for $750 a pop.
Jesus.
The game's on TV. No, sit home for the same money, chase the dragon. Just sit there and fucking enjoy yourself. You're not even shooting up.
I mean, those Southerners love college football. I'll say that about them.
Just not college.
They pack in 100,000 people every
Here's
game.
The thing they love down in Florida right now. College football and the Rays.
They don't love the Rays.
There's a fever going on.
There is no fever. That fever has broke before it even started.
Michael, you're on Ramon Fez.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hey, what's going on, buddy?
You tell me, dude.
All right. I'm 10 blocks from Tropicana Dome. I live, my condo's here in downtown St. Pete, and Fez, were you even near St. Petersburg? Because obviously you didn't see all the people wearing Rays gear. I've never seen, I've been here 10 years now, I've never seen people wearing Rays gear like they do. People are out and about in the streets. People, you go to Ferg's across from the stadium, the place is full.
Yes,
people,
it's the bar next to the stadium. Of course it's going to be full.
Why are you angry?
Because they are misrepresenting. I saw more people walking around that area with Yankee hats on.
It is, well, you haven't been to a game this year, because the last time the Yankees
were
down, they were being outrooted. There were more Rays fans in the stands, and I can guarantee you a lot of them were, you know, bandwagon types that jump ship. I even saw a dude with a Yankees tattoo on his ankle wearing a Rays gear.
That's so, it. That's a fucking even... Yankees fan for you. Who's first?
All right, guys. You be good.
Peace. And... here's Brian. Brian, you're on the Fez.
DOB 1980, my body.
Hey, body. Yes.
Hey, you're all talking about the Curtis Blow recordings. What about Robert Johnson and Hank Williams back in the 20s and 30s?
Fabulous.
Still sounded better.
Way better.
Earl?
So, yeah. While you're giving fucking hip-hop all these things, they came 50 years after Robert Johnson.
I understand.
A man who you never fucking heard of. Because you don't know your own heritage.
I absolutely know the history of Robert
Would
Johnson.
You then go to the crossroads and sell your soul to the devil?
I wouldn't sell my soul.
Then let's do this. Jesus, Earl's soul is gone now. Belongs to the devil. Do not let him in the gates of heaven.
No.
It was a simpler time around the 80s. Video games.
See, Ronald Reagan was the president.
There was this hit show, Head of the Class.
People didn't understand things like Cheers.
Rubik's Cube. What an amazing piece of work.
There was something called parachute pants that was so roomy. And that's why the song Basketball got so popular.
Iran-Contra.
Hey, Joe Biden's got a cute little wife too, huh?
Yeah, Jill Biden.
The JJs.
The whole, yep. That whole family's great looking.
Even Bo?
There's this one teenage daughter on the
Bo and Hunter
on the Biden family. Woo.
They all got good-looking families.
Yeah, they do.
McCain's family's adorable.
Yeah, and those two girls, Obama's girls, are beautiful.
Then McCain said he doesn't even know how many houses he has, and everyone's laughing at him. It's because it's his chick's money.
Yeah. She's good-looking.
Yeah, she's hot.
Her father was a beer baron.
Didn't they play the Rays?
To a less than sold out crowd.
JT, you're on Ron and Fez. JT, go ahead, buddy. We lost you. He said 32,000 fans at the last Rays game.
That's not a sellout.
Why do you come back with bad information?
I did not come back with bad information. I said
you
that
were
game,
telling me 14,000.
I said it wasn't sold out.
Did you not tell us 14,000?
I may have.
You're off by 18,000. here's Jim. Jim, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ron. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, bud.
Without a doubt, the most ridiculous sports ticket to get a hold of by far is the Masters. You literally have to have them things handed down. You can't even buy one.
Yeah, but I don't even understand that. You don't even get a fucking seat. Then you got to walk around and follow? The hell with that. I'll wait here. I can't understand the other game. No, you just follow him.
You don't get to see 99% of the participants.
You think every single time you're missing most of the action.
It's ridiculous.
It's like if you had football tickets, but you could just see the guard's feet. Oh, God, what else is happening? His feet look great, but what else is happening out there?
And what if you're not stuck with Tiger? I mean,
here, this was also on the HBO Sports thing. Give me worldwide the three most gambled on sports. Dave,
horse
first.
Racing, boxing, college football.
Lil?
I was going to say horse racing would probably be the biggest.
Okay.
Do I need two more?
Yeah.
Yeah, basketball? I have no idea. I don't know what people bet.
Fezzy?
I'm going to say horse racing first, followed by soccer, followed by pro football.
Wrong. Horse racing, it goes like this. Soccer's first.
Oh, okay. Man.
Followed by horse racing. Followed by tennis.
No way.
More people gamble on tennis worldwide than gamble on professional football.
That's insane.
You're insane.
Tennis.
Yeah. Well, it came up because they're fixing tennis stuff.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that.
Fixing fucking tennis matches.
But, I mean, what, just people betting for Federer every fucking time? I mean, no.
They bet all kinds of weird ones. I didn't know it was that popular a world sport.
I wouldn't have thought so. I wouldn't have thought it has any following in Asia or Russia. Well, I guess Russia, maybe.
Russia's huge.
Yeah.
Big European sport.
But South America? Tennis?
I love it down there. Really? They're crazy about it. They go out of their minds.
Even in Australia. It is. They have an Australian Open.
Pat Cash.
So? Johnny Cash. How's that? Let's all fucking play this game. All right. We are back. Fez, you're going to be back tomorrow?
Yes, I am.
I can't wait. Can't wait till you come back tomorrow.
I will be back tomorrow. Noon in the East.
I forgot this song when we were on vacation. It's really a song about a satellite, like our own radio broadcast song. But this satellite spreads love. And that's how I like to think of our show, spreading love.
Oh, shit! Fucking rib shot.
Get it now?
No. That spread some ribs.
You're sensitive, Davey.
Well, you hit me 5 times a month in the ribs.
It's love.
It is. It's a satellite of love.
Yeah.
Lily, tomorrow I want you to bring in spaghetti sauce.
Okay.
Mmm.
Got something to plug there, Watley?
This weekend, Unmasked with Tommy Chong is going to debut Saturday at 8 p.m. in the East on XM Comedy 150, and then Sunday, 2 p.m. Eastern on XM 202 right here on The Virus. That's Unmasked with Tommy Chong.
Congratulations to the Rays for selling out.
They didn't.
On Sunday. You did it, Rays.
They did nothing.
Fez lied. You did it.
Mm-mm.
And coming soon, I don't want everybody else is going to be able to go to Florio's with Fez.
You have to be paying attention. Some of these things are organized last second.
Why couldn't Casey come?
Someone had to watch the baby.
That's what mom was there for.
Right.
One last thing, and don't forget this. This is very important.
And that's the end of my show. Donk.
Ron Bennington, Fez Watley. It's the Ron and Fez Show.